Okay, so again a very good afternoon students. Yeah, can you please extend the deadline? But which deadline you are talking about? We'll discuss that later in the free time, but don't worry about it. Fine, lab is okay. I'll see. Don't worry. Fine, just let we are going to focus on our today's topic, then we'll discuss about that. Fine. So in the last lecture we were discussing about the OSI model. Find the different layers of OSI model, where we get to know just a quick review about the OSI model. Fine. So OSI model is just a theoretical model. Fine, we have already discussed, and we have discussed that it has seven layers, where each layer has its own role and its own responsibility, which include application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. Fine. In the application, we talked about that this particular layer invoked when your network aware applications, when your network aware applications get invoked. Fine. Yeah, yeah, bache, don't worry. I'm going to repeat it. Fine. Don't worry about it. So in the application layer, when we talk about that, all our network aware applications done, for example, Firefox, Google Chrome, or any application to which internet is being used, we say this application layer gets invoked. Fine. If we talk about the presentation layer, its main role is to encrypt the data or to decrypt the provide encryption, data compression, to present your data in a more in a way such that it will be easily readable to the humans. Because the after the presentation layer, data is going to be reached to the application layer on the other end. So whatever the data is going to be visible to the end users, it should be in a presentable form. Fine. So in the presentation layer, your data compression techniques are being used. Fine, to present your data in a good way. Then comes the session. We know that there are multiple applications running onto your system or any other particular device. For that, different sessions are being created. The session layer helps in creating the different sessions for the each and every particular application, so that it would be easy for them to manage and they will be easily get continued with the different applications running at a time. Then then I said that these three layers are the responsibility of your operating system. As a network administrator, we generally don't deal with it. Fine, it's your the task of the particular applications which are running, part task of the operating system. Fine. Now comes the transport layer. This is the responsibility of a particular network administrator. Fine. So in the transport layer, your connection which has to be built with the other device, it needs to be handled at the transport layer. Fine. The data is in the form of segments. We get to know that the whatever the data coming from the whatever the data which is coming from the session layer while reaching at the transport layer, at the packet, the transport layer add its header. After adding the header, the packet becomes the data becomes the in the form of segment. Fine. Transport layer helps in providing two connection tree protocols. Fine, which is TCP and UDP. TCP refers to transmission control protocol and UDP refers to user data ground protocol. Fine. So it is a connection oriented. The UDP is the connection less. Fine. Whereas in case of retransmission of packets, TCP is reliable. Whereas in case of UDP, it is not reliable. Sir, please explain application layer. Someone has posed a doubt. Yeah. Sir, please explain application layer once. I suffered audio loss due to connectivity. Don't worry, bache. Sir, I'll explain it to you at 2:30, 2 or 2:25. Don't worry. Fine. Okay. So in the transport layer, when we talk about that TCP, either it can be TCP protocol or UDP protocol. That means retransmission of packets is done. That's why TCP is reliable, but my connection speed is slow in case of TCP. Whereas if I want to make a connection which is very fast, but the retransmission of packets is not reliable, I'll choose UDP. So basically, UDP protocol is being used when I want to see a live match, when I need to transmit the audio files or the video files. In that case, generally UDP works fine. In case of normal data transmission, fine. TCP connection is made because we are talking about the reliability of the data, so that's why it is being used fine. Then your port number is also being included in the transport layer, because there are different applications which are running. There are different applications which are sharing data, so they must know that to which port whatever the protocol is running, to which port it has to send. For example, if a protocol like in the application layer, for example, DHCP is running fine. I have already told there are different protocols like DHCP, DNS. We have FTP protocol, SNMP, SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol. So these are the all protocols which have been running at the each of the layer. Fine. In application layer, dynamic host configuration protocol, domain name, FTP file transport protocol, simple mail transport. These all are protocols running, but they all run at different port number. Fine. For example, for DNS, we have the port number of 67 and 68 for the server and for the client. Then for the DHCP, we have different port numbers. So there are approximately 1 to 66,600 approximately different port numbers which are available on which these protocols are been running. So I'll suggest you guys to please have a look at these list of the different port numbers and to which these port numbers are working. You must remember some of the port number fine for the HTTP or the for SMTP simple mail transfer protocol, for the FTP, DNS and DHCP fine. So it will be very easy for you guys to remember it. Just remember the port number for it fine. Then when the segment, then this segment, data segment, fine. When it reaches from transport layer to network layer, what network layer does is network layer add its own header, which include IP address. Why IP address is because we know that at the network layer, routers works and routers are going to, when routers, routers maintain the table of the IP addresses because they are the more intelligent device. They know that to which particular device they need to route that packet. So network, when the data segment reaches network layer, it adds its own header, make that segment and convert that segment into a packet. That means your data will be in the form of packet when it reaches to network layer. Fine. So that's for what purpose it is being used. Then all the routing protocols. Fine. For example, your RIP dynamic protocols like RIP, OSPF, RIP, OSPF, EID, RP. So these are the different protocols which are being running in the network layer. So we'll discuss that in the later part when we have the explanation of each of the routing protocol. Then what is the administrative distance of each routing protocol? What is the hop count? What are the matrices which we need to be take care of? So we'll all discuss all that things in our later section. Fine. Right now we just need to focus on the OSI model and the different protocols which are in running in that particular layer, because each layer has its own functionality. Each layer has its own role. Fine. Now then comes the switches. Fine. So switch works. Then comes the data link layer. So fine. When the data reaches from network layer to the data link layer, what it does, it actually adds its own again header and make that packet into the frames. That means your data at the data link layer is in the form of frames. Fine. That's how it works. So these are the different parts upon which these layers are working. Switch works in the data link layer. Switch is more intelligent than the hub because it understands the MAC address of a system, which is physical addressing, which means logical addressing is being done at the network layer and the physical addressing is being done at the data link layer. Fine. So we all must remember it. And also one of the most important thing which need to be taken care of data link layer is your error redundancy algorithms. Fine. Error redundancy, DUNDAC algorithms. Fine. your CRC, because whenever the data needs to be carried, fine, and along any transmission mode, fine, because this transmission can be guided or this can be unguided medium, fine, this can be guided or unguided medium, any particular medium to which you want to transfer the data, fine. But for that, whether your data is successfully reaching to the other end or not, we need to check it, because while transferring the data might be some error which can be get into the any of the packet or any of the data, or I can say in the frame. So it need to be checked that at the data link layer, whether the data which is going to be received or which is being sent has been correct or not. Fine, this is the actually functionality of data link layer. Then comes the physical layer. Fine, in the physical layer, actually your transferring of data into bits actually done. That means whatever the data is being sent from this coming from these above layers, when it reaches the physical layer, your data is actually going to be transferred in the form of bits, which can be 0 or 1. Fine, anything that depend upon the data. This is just an example, bache. So it need to actually convert that data into the bits, because computer understand only bits, and through the guided channel or the unguided channel, these bits are being going to be transferred from one end to the other end. And again, when the data reaches to the other end, it again need to be passed through these different layers. At this layer, it check the bits. At the data link layer, it check for the any kind of errors. In the route network layer, it check for the it again remove the header and make the packet. Then it comes to transport layer, then session layer, then presentation encrypt that, make it in a make the data in a presentable way, and the application layer provide the actually the end user to see that view data to communicate with that particular PC, and it then reaches to the other device. So these are the protocols. These are the standards upon which the OSI model works, but it is just a theoretical model. Fine, that is being provided or implemented by the ISO organization. That's how the functionality of OSI model works. Fine. So till now, any doubt to anyone? But till now, any doubt to anyone? Are we sure? It's easy. I think sure. So okay, fine. So let me just quickly create a question for you guys. Okay, I'll do it later. Fine, let's just continue with our topic. Fine, so are we good to go with the other part? Fine. So next come this slide. Fine, again some repeating. So the data has to be done in process in this way. Fine. From the seventh layer to 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, where by passing each layer, the header is going to be attached according to the functionality of each layer, and physical layer actually transmission of bits happened, and it transmitted through a medium and reaches to the other end, and finally reaches to B. That's how working of OSI model is. Fine. So you can see the summary from here, layers, which I have already explained in a very good way to you guys. So you have to now just have a quick review about it, and it will be all clear to you. Fine, just for your advantage. Fine. Now coming to the second model. Now we have already discussed that OSI model is just a theoretical model. Now whatever the functioning of the above three layers, which is physical, which is application layer or session layer or presentation layer, now that task is need to be performed by this particular application layer. Fine. So in the TCP/IP model, we have only four layers: application layer, transport layer, internet layer, and network access layer. Fine. So this is a practical model which is currently running into our many of the companies follow these particular model for the standard protocols. So the functioning of the application layer in TCP/IP model is to present the data to user, to encode and session control. That means whatever the functioning which are been controlling in the OSI model by three of the layers, now it need to be done by a single layer in the application. It is a more rare model, more practical model. That's why it is being implemented. That means only a single layer can handle all these things. It doesn't need to make the different players, like in the OSI model, fine. It was just a reference model which was being used, fine. Then comes the transport layer, fine. It is a kind of support of communication between diverse devices and network. Same way we talk about that, either it is a TCP connection or we have to make UDP connection, or we have to make on which port number it is working. First, the data is going to be divided. When the data is going to be reached from application layer, the data is going to be divided into different segments. Then it need to provide the it need to provide the TCP or the UDP connection for the devices to communicate with each other. Fine. Now after this, the data is going to be reached to the internet layer. Internet layer, we know that routers work at this layer, so it determines the path in the network to which the data packets need to be routed. For that, we can use either static routing, fine, or we can use dynamic routing, fine. We have all these advantages and disadvantages of the sum of the static routing and dynamic. If my network is very small, because we generally deal with the different IP addresses, fine, we generally deal with the different networks, and for that the data needs to be routed. And for that, the one thing also we remember that we need gateway for a particular packet to go to some other end or to go to some of the other network, fine. That is being used in terms of routing. Static routing, if my network is very small, just 2 to 3 devices, and I am the network administrator, I can use the static routing. But the problems come when I have a very large network. I have more inter-networking device, I have more networking device, I have more PCs, computers, etc., everything. Then it's not possible as being an administrator to manage the routing purpose as manually. So what we do, we use the dynamic routing protocols, fine, which include into the two parts, the IGP, fine, and the second category is EGP, interior gateway protocols and exterior gateway protocols, fine. By means of interior gateway protocols and the categories which are in the IGP are RIP are being used, fine, OSPF, EAGRP, these are the use. Exterior gateway, when the packet need to be reached to some other network or other gateway, fine. That's why these categories are used. In this, we have BGP, border gateway protocols, so fine. So we'll discuss each and every protocols as we go day by day into deep of the concepts of the computer networking, fine. Then we have the network access, fine. In this, it controls the hardware, it controls the component of the network, fine. So we know that if I am a network administrator, if something happened to my cables, if something happened to my any of the hardware, so I first go to the physical device, physical layer in the OSI model. That's as being a responsibility of network administrator, I should know that what is the functioning of each layer and to which layer I should go and to make the things correct. Because we take an example of university, we might can have some different problems in the university related to some of our student ID, related to some of our fees, related to some of our studies or the books. So we should know that to which particular source person we have to go. That's why these layering have been done. These standard protocols have been done by the International Standard Organization, so that it would be easy for us to, that if I know that I have this problem related to accounts department, I'll definitely directly go to accounts. I do not need to go some HR or our own department. So I should know that, fine. That's why this layering is being done. Someone has raised his hand. Is someone want to ask any doubt, bache? You may ask. You may ask if someone has doubt till now. Please make the class more interactive. It's not like that I am only one going to be like in the class. You should also do some show some input. Are these all things clear to you guys, everyone? There are 80 students present in my class and everything is clear to everyone. Bache, are you there? Everything is clear to you. That means either you are scientist or you are listening to me in a very good way, or I can assume that everything is very clear to you. Please explain IGP again. Bache, see, these are just the categories, two broader categories in the dynamic routing, IGP and EGP. Interior gateway protocols, exterior gateway protocols. Right now, we just need to focus. I just don't go at the start into the deep. Fine. I just don't want you guys to confuse. Fine. We have the whole full chapter in the other session. Fine. Don't worry about it. Different categories which we have is the RIP. In the dynamic, we have RIP. We just need to remember this routing information protocol. Then the other category we have is OSPF, open shortest path first. We are going to learn that how these routing protocol works, how they are going to build a particular network route to the other networks. Fine. We are going to learn about this. Fine. We have EAGRP. We are going to learn about it. What are the problems which we have in RIP, like counting to infinity problem, or if the administrative distance of RIP is 120, what it is, what we mean by this. If the OSPF administrative distance is 110 and the EAGRP administrative distance is 90. Fine. Right now, in our most of the companies, these two are protocols being used. Fine. So I can use any of the routing protocol in my company. Fine. That's it. Now, one question I have for you guys. Just listen to me very clearly. For example, I have two companies. Let me clear this. Can I clear all this, whatever I written over there? Just raise your hand so I'll get to know that. Is this fine to you guys? Not fine. Now, one question to all you guys. Fine. If someone has already been into the networking field or someone has some brief introduction about it. Now, let's suppose there are two companies. Fine. This is the one company which is some of my friend, and this is my company. Fine. In my company, the routing protocol which has been worked for the dynamic is OSPF. Fine. And the routing protocol which has been working in one of my friend's company is EIGRP. Fine. Now, see my friend's company going to the loss. Now he will not be able to run that company. What it does, it says, please buy my company. Fine. Now I am going to overtake that company. Now the thing is, my whole company network is on OSPF. His whole company's routing, dynamic routing is on EIGRP protocol. Fine. Now I want to overtake it so that both these companies can get together with it, and I need to make the network between these two companies and make the communication happen and synchronize everything. So will it possible for me or for the network administrator that if one of my protocol for the network is running on OSPF and one of my network which is protocol on EIGRP, can we communicate both these network with each other? Let me just quickly create a poll and you have to answer yes or no. Fine. So can we connect two different, can we connect two different routing protocols with each other? Fine. You have to just answer yes or no. Just think about it. Take 10 to 15 seconds, think about it, that if you are answering anything that yes or no, you must have an explanation for that. Fine. Whatever you are answering, I'll get to know about it, and I will be asking from you guys by making you a presenter so that you will be able to speak, that if you have answered yes, what is the reason behind it, or if you have answered no, what is the reason behind it. So right now I can see 14 people have responded. Bache, quickly respond. It's not like that we are going to give you 5 minutes for the polling. It's just that you have 10 to 15 seconds to answer that question. So I just request you guys to please answer it quickly. Still 49 left. Abhishek Chauhan, Abhishek Goyal, Abhishek Singh, Aditya Yadav, Adya Srivastav, Akash Gupta, Akash Mohr, Akshay Aswani, Amrit Kaur, Ankush Singh, Arpit Gupta, Banu Agarwal, Shavi, Gaurav Agarwal, Hardik Lath, Harishet, Himanshu, Jaskirat, Jatin Dua, Jatin Kakkar, Khushi. Bache, please answer quickly, hurry up. 20 more students left. Raghav Khemka, Saurabh Sharma, Shalyesh, your network is over, Bache. शुभम कुमार स्टिल 11 स्टूडेंट लेफ्ट. हरिया बच्चे जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट दैट कैन वी कनेक्ट टू डिफरेंट डायनेमिक राउटिंग प्रोटोकॉल्स विद ईच अदर. स्टिल 8 लेफ्ट. डू आई नीड टू सलियेश डू आई नीड टू नोट डाउन दीज एंट्रीज और वी आर गोइंग टू डू इट. हरिया बच्चे जस्ट 5 मोर सेकेंड्स टू यू गाइस. 7 मोर लेफ्ट. Why you guys are not responded, bache? Who left with 8 responses, 7 responses? Jatin Kakkar. So I should need to take that report that whether you guys are going to respond or not. Fine. So I note it down. Don't worry. I have every report with me. Fine. So I am going to end this poll. Fine. The correct answer is the one. Yes, we can connect. The OSPF with the EAGRP, we have a concept of redistribution of packets. Fine, we have the concept in our networking, which is redistribution. So you can connect the two different routing protocols with each other if you want to, which include the concept of this. We'll do that in our one of the lab. Fine, 65 has answered yes, very right, bache. And still 8 other responses with 7 responses are non-respondent. So I have noted it down and your reports will be generated. Fine. So thank you. So I hope this is clear to you. Fine. So quickly moving to the next part. So just some detail about the layers in the TCP/IP. Fine. It is a reference model, practical model. Does not discuss these layer too much. The node should connect to the network with the protocol, such as it can send IP packets, mostly in hardware and also known as the network interface layer. I am talking about the network access. Fine. Then we have the second layer is internet layer. We can have the connectionless point-to-point internet networking, take care of the routing across the multiple networks, that routing protocols. Each packet travel in the network independently of each other. They might not arrive or they might arrive out of the order. These are the problem which we can get in a particular network. We'll be able to see that how we are going to control it or how we are going to perform these matrices. Which one is earlier, OSI or TCP? Bache, which one you are talking? In the last lecture, we discussed TCP. In this particular lecture, we started with the TCP/IP model. In the OSI model, we have 7 layers. In the TCP/IP model, we just have 4 layers. Bache. Abbas, is it clear to you? Abbas, Mehdi? No. What is that you are not getting it? Can you please explain me? Which one is earlier, OSI or TCP? Bache, what is the issue? Please hurry up quickly. Or just note it down. I'll take your query at the last. If you are taking some time. Fine. So, okay. Very good. So internet layer, sir is asking which of the one is older. Older one, which one? OSI came, acha, okay, older one. OSI came first, then comes the TCP/IP. OSI is old because first comes the theoretical model, then comes the practical model. Fine. In the earlier time, the ISO, International Standard Organization, made the contribution of the OSI model, fine, theoretical model. At the same time, after some time, the defense company comes into the existence and they approach for the TCP/IP model. They made that TCP/IP model, which is a practical model and currently running in most of our companies. Fine. So, okay, clear, very good. So then the transport layer, it is responsible for end-to-end transfer. Transmission control protocol, in that we have connection oriented. There is a reliability of data. There is a ordering of data. Fine. Whereas in the user datagram protocol, it is a connectionless service. Delivery of the packets is not guaranteed. Fine. So I just want to again check for you guys that whether TCP or UDP is clear to you guys or not. So in TCP, whether, just one question more for you guys, whether the transmission is done or not. The transmission of packet, just one second, bache, is done or not. Fine. So you have to answer that question again, yes or no. So yeah, one more question to you guys. In TCP, whether retransmission of packets is done or not, and what do you have? Are you guys able to make it consider that if the retransmission of the packet is done in case of TCP/IP? So can I say that whether my TCP/IP is good, whether my TCP/IP is more efficient than the UDP? Can I say that? Very right. Very right, okay, Murli. Yes, depend upon the type of data. Very right. Yes, I cannot say that if my retransmission of the data is being done in case of TCP, I cannot say that my TCP is better than UDP. It all depend upon which type of transmission to do. In case your data reliability is more than your connection speed, we'll choose TCP. In case when we want to transfer some audio files, some video files, live match we want to see, we'll prefer UDP connection because we want the data processing at a much faster rate. And the second thing is, I can say UDP is better. Fine. In case of TCP, whether retransmission of packet is done or not, yes, it is being done. Fine, you have to answer. So I think this is clear to you guys. Fine. Is this clear to you guys? Fine. So let me quickly move to the application layer. Fine. So application layer supports for the user application. We have a separate module for each different application. We have different protocols like HTTP, SMTP, telnetting refers to the telnetting refers to means of saying that when I want to do remote login access. Fine, we'll discuss that in the second lab, that how we are going to implement telnetting. We have a BTP line cables available from line BTY 0 to 15. We are going to see how we are going to enable that. Fine. That comprises the TCP/IP protocol. I have already explained all these protocols, so I just give you guys 1 to 1.5 minutes to read all these particular protocols which are mentioned here, and I quickly ask you. Fine. So just take 2 minutes and read all these protocols which are mentioned. So are we clear with this? Yeah, bache, I have given you time to read all these protocols. I have given you time to read all these protocols which I have already explained you to guys. I was not saying for the 30 seconds. I was not speaking for the 30 seconds. Fine. Does anybody know about ARP protocol? Anyone want to speak? You have the options available. I have already given you audio rights. Fine. So does anyone want to explain what is ARP? Or should I take the name from your 80 students that you have to answer? Divanshi, Garvit Saxena. Does anyone know that what purpose ARP is being used? Bache, you can speak. You have the audio right and speak in my class. Please make it more interactive. Are you there, Garvit Saxena? Vamsi, you want to speak something, bache?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, ARP IP उस एक particular function perform करता है, sir.
Okay. IP what type of function?
मतलब हार्डवेयर रिसोर्स का एड्रेस लोग फाइंड करना फिर उसके थ्रू कनेक्शन टाइप्स
ओके एनीबॉडी एल्स इन द क्लास
हेलो
यागुरदीप
सर एआरपी हमारा प्रोटोकॉल होता है जिससे हमें अभी अपने किसी आईपी एड्रेस का जो आईपी एड्रेस पे जो होस्ट है उसका हमें मैक एड्रेस नहीं पता है हमें बस उसका नेटवर्क एड्रेस पता है कि उसका नेटवर्क एड्रेस है लेकिन हमें उसका मैक एड्रेस ढूंढना है तो वो एक ब्रॉडकास्ट मैसेज भेजेगा सभी को और बोलेगा जो भी मतलब जो भी ये वाले मैक एड्रेस का वो है उससे रिस्पांस लेगा फिर वापस
वेरी राइट बचे, वेरी राइट, फाइन. फॉर दैट पर्पस एआरपी प्रोटोकॉल इज बीइंग यूज्ड, फाइन. सो बचे, व्हेनेवर वी नीड टू ट्रांसमिट सम डेटा फ्रॉम द वन नेटवर्क, लेट्स सपोज टू अदर नेटवर्क, फाइन. दीज आर टू नेटवर्क एंड देयर इज अ डिवाइस, देयर इट इज, एंड दीज नेटवर्क्स आर बीइंग मेड. नाउ आई नीड टू मेक ट्रांसमिशन फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर डिवाइस व्हिच इज इन सम अदर नेटवर्क. Now, when this device send a request, it does know the network, but it doesn't know that to which particular device it need to send that request. For example, if I need some data in your class, fine. In your class, I need to know that to which UID I want to which for which particular UID I need the data. So I must need that. I need the name. I need the UID also. The names of a student which can be same, but the UID is always going to be the different, fine. So whenever a request is being sent, it knows the IP address and it doesn't know the MAC address. First request in that case will also be unsuccessful, fine. So then what it does, it takes a ARC packet. ARC packet is being sent to all the devices that I have a request for this particular IP address, but I do not remember the MAC address of that particular device. So what it device does, it takes that ARC packet, update the MAC address for its request and will send back to that particular PC to which from which it the ARC packet, that purpose for which it is being used, fine. So these are the different protocols which have been running. So I request you to guys, please look into some details about the port number and the working of these protocols, some of which I have already explained to you guys. For example, DNS, it is being used to resolve an IP address. It is being used to convert an IP address into a name or a name into the IP address, fine. Network file sharing, it is being used when we transfer some data files, we need that protocol. For the dynamic allocation of IP address to the different devices, we use this DHCP protocol. Earlier it was BOOTP protocol which was being used, but it was not done the automatic IP address. BOOTP also the protocol which is being used, fine. Then we have for the network management SNMP, simple network protocol. Then we have ROM, fine. So you guys just need to look into all these protocols and just learn some working of this and we'll be able to get back, fine. So by moving to the next slide, fine. These are some of the key points which we have discussed in till now, that data communication or the transfer, data communication or the transfer of the data from one device to another device, some mode of any transmission media which can be guided or which can be unguided. A data communication system must transmit the data to correct destination in a accurate and timely manner. Text numbers, images, audios, videos are different of information, fine. Then we have discussed that data flow between two devices can occur in three way, which can be simplex, half duplex or full duplex. Half duplex means only the data can be sent from only one side. That means if sender and receiver are communicating with each other, fine, only one can send. Then for the full duplex, both the communication can be done in the point to point connection. Two and only two devices are connected by a dedicated link, which we have seen in the mesh point to point connection. In the multipoint, there are three or more devices share a link with each other, fine. Then topology refers to physical or logical arrangement. Devices may be in mesh, star, bus, ring. So a network can be categorized as a local area network or the wide area network. So there are a local, regional, national, international internet service providers. We have different ISPs, and a protocol is the rule of set that governs the data communication, which we have seen that either we are going to use OSI model, which is a theoretical. Right now implementation practical is of TCP/IP model, fine. And the key element of protocol are syntax, semantic and the timings, fine. So I hope that till now whatever we have discussed, it is being clear to you guys. So all the references have been attached. If you want to learn something more about the lectures we have discussed till now, all the content is already being included in your Blackboard account. So now any queries to you guys, if you have any queries, so I just 5 minutes I am giving you query, giving the time to you guys if you have any query related to anything. Fine. So we'll say we'll shall discuss it, and in the next lecture we are going to start with our next presentation. Yeah, Gurdeep Muskan, link layer address discover करने के लिए use होता है. अच्छा सर, कैन यू प्लीज एक्सप्लेन नेट प्रोटोकॉल, नेटवर्क एड्रेस ट्रांसलेशन. बचे सी, देर आर टू आई पी एड्रेसेज विच आर बींग यूज, द वन इज पब्लिक आई पी एड्रेस एंड वन इज द प्राइवेट आई पी एड्रेस. वी नो दैट ऑन अवर मशीन वी आर हैविंग अ प्राइवेट आई पी एड्रेस, येस और नो, विच आर बींग असाइन टू अस. नाउ इफ आई नीड टू कनेक्ट टू अ पर्टिकुलर इंटरनेट, आई नीड अ public IP address. Fine, for that purpose translation of that particular IP address is we need network address translation. For that purpose it is being used, NAT protocol, network address translation, because without public IP address we cannot connect to a particular network on the internet. Hardik, is it clear to you? Hardik, is it clear to you bache? Sure bache, any doubt to anyone other? I am here for you guys. Please make the class more interactive. Fine, because I don't want it the communication from just my end. Fine, please share the PPT. Bache, your PPTs are already in your Blackboard account. You have to open that Chrome package and see the PPT. It will be available over. It is available over there, and you will be able to see. I think I have made it visible to you all guys. If it is not, I will be able by today. If it is not visible to you, let me check and I'll share it with you guys just after 2:30. Fine, just within 5 minutes it's visible. Someone is saying it's visible. How is that possible if it is visible to someone and not visible to others? Okay, fine. Any other doubt to any particular one? Any doubt related to this particular subject, or till now the things which we have discussed you are not getting it, or the have you all attached the experiment? Sure. So we all are on same page. We all are understanding the concepts. We are learning that for what purpose, for what thing, why we are going to need that particular computer network. Is it clear? Is it start clearing to you guys? Yes, sure. So fine. Okay, so still 2 minutes left. Fine, if someone has doubt, or you can post you can send your queries to me at prabjot.e8624, or you can contact me. Fine, I'm already added in your group. I think so. My contact number is 8556058170. Only queries related to this particular subject, computer network. Fine, no other queries. Your whatever your attendance, or it is going to be marked on CMS. Check it over there. Fine, sir. Application layer explain once. Bache, see, now see that whenever a network aware application runs onto my operating system or any of the device, my application layer gets involved. Now, what do you mean by this? That means all the application which are related to the app, which are connected to the internet. And when they run, only at that time application layer gets invoked. It is also being used to provide the communication between the end users and the different applications also. Fine, we are able to interact with the different application software running on our operating system. It's all also possible of the application layer. Fine, if I remove the network interface card from my device, or my application is not being connected to the particular internet, my application layer will not get invoked in any particular time. You might can read it somewhere that your application layer invokes all the applications which are currently on your system, but it's not like that. Sir, only those application which are network layer, for that the network application which are network connected, for that application layer get invoked. That's it. So I hope this is clear to you guys. Fine, so please give your feedback. It is always being mandatory. Fine, please give your feedback so that we can improve the things, and we will be meeting in the next lecture. Fine, thank you for your responses bache. Please respond everyone, whatever you are feeling, your feedback, happy, surprise, was it faster or was it slower our lecture. थैंक्स फॉर योर फीडबैक. समवन इज सरप्राइज्ड. त्रिशांक ठाकुर इज सरप्राइज. बच्चे व्हाई यू आर सरप्राइज्ड त्रिशांक ठाकुर. थैंक यू बच्चे. सो विल बी मीटिंग, टेक सम रेस्ट एंड विल बी मीटिंग इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. थैंक यू.